As good as the Edgewood boys golf team has been in recent years, they still play in the shadow of dominance displayed by the Crusaders girls golf program, which has produced 8 straight state titles. Today, the boys start a streak of their own. Platteville's Josh Udelhoffen, happy to be putting that umbrella away and resume his charge at the individual D-2 title. He taps in at 18 for a final round 76. That's good for second place, 6 shots back. A bitter, still somewhat sweet finish for the season for the Hillman standout, though. Here's Scott Hurd at 14. The Edgewood star chips it off the flag stick. He goes on to a 76. Gage Maurer at 18 sinks the putt. Maurer with an 84. Tough conditions on the day, though, where every stroke mattered in their battle with Xavier. Comes down to last hole. Stefan caps the day with a 78 with a tap in at 18. Crusaders hang on to defend a title that many thought not possible after losing Cody Strang a year ago. Here's a look at the final scores for you. The Crusaders by 2 shots over Xavier. That's just how close it was. McFarland finishes 4th. And Dan Osga, who finished 2nd a year ago for Edgerton, finishes 5th after a bounce-back round today. But let's hear from the champions.
The girls have won a lot. We're nowhere near what the girls have done, but you know, it's incredible to win 2 in a row. It's tough to win the state tournament.
People didn't think that we could come back and win after losing Cody and 2 other seniors, and you know, we just overcame that and proved people wrong by winning.
Very frustrating at times, but I had fun. I wanted to win state. I mean, if I take 2nd, if I don't, I had a good time.
The Division I champions would not be crowned until late in the evening. Mitch Johnson of Middleton, they took a 1-shot lead into the final round at number 1. Johnson with a very nice approach. It leads to a par. He cards a final round 8 over par to finish tied for 7th. Also at number 1 is the Cardinals teammate Mike Schilling out of the waterlogged bunker. Looks to be no problem. He shoots a 3 over 75. He is your individual winner by 1 stroke. Middleton, though, finishes in 3rd place, 4 shots back of state champ Arrowhead. Sun Prairie ties for 12th. Memorial 14th. For Schilling, taking the individual crown is bittersweet.
I'm just ecstatic that I won individual. It's huge. It was another goal of mine, winning my conference and winning state. So it's 2 goals realized, but really wanted that team championship.
In Division 3, this is Barneveld's Lucas Danz making the putt on his final hole today. Cuba City's Eric Wolf teed off early this morning in 2nd, just 2 shots out of the lead, but an 89 today resulted in his medal for a 6th place finish. Chris Allen of Cambridge entered the final round tied for 2nd with Wolf, but ballooned to an 89 today, and he's still tied for 6th. So a look at the team champions. Cuba City falls to a 4th place finish. Acadia wins the title with 97. That's 4 shots better, 97 over par, better than St. Mary's.